I do spara, but what lum buikas a harch, the gok aine, agus maclan, a hug takio dumse, agus doshim fein. It's more an omus a vet in a chakta dale, la hoig dina in malia aclea, here hui. Dina eglurig ahru, agus tashe la fecal, nak will ain dina tuffe, o fina fall, no fina gale, and macianter. On tain arch a harla isho. Johnny made my shocked in yehel, a gober marial er gok dinne, near one a dinne na hoga vote doing. It's a very proud day for me to be here today as a Sinn Féin TD. I want to thank the people of Dublin North West for the mandate that they have given to me to represent them and their interests. We are the only constituency in the state that didn't return a Fianna Fáil or Fine Gael TD. And that reflects the mood of change that my team and I encountered during the election campaign. I wish also to thank my family and all those who worked tirelessly to put forward the Sinn Féin message that there is a better way. I was elected to stand up for ordinary working people and families in areas like Finglas, Ballymun, Santry, Whitehall and Beaumont. I will use my position here to fight for their rights, for the unemployed, the sick, the vulnerable, hard-working, low- and middle-income families who have been pushed to the brink by the last government. In the course of the election campaign, Sinn Féin set out its stall for a better and fairer society, that there is an alternative to the status quo, and that Sinn Féin is that alternative. In considering the motion we have before us on the programme for government, it is frustrating to see how little detail there is in what the new government has put forward. However, there are at least one thing clear. One of the opening sentences in the programme is, the new government supports the objectives of the EU IMF programme of support. So this new government has set out very clearly that they intend to continue with the policies of savage cuts which the last government pursued and served only to prolong and deepen the present recession. One of the planks of the IMF plan, as we have seen in Greece, has been the wholesale sell-off of state assets. I note with deep concern that in this programme for government, the Labour Party have apparently signed up to the Fine Gael plan for the sell-off of non-strategic state assets. Of course, they provide no detail on what precisely are non-strategic assets. However, I have no doubt that this is a plan for privatisation. The programme for government states that they will sell off up to 2 billion of state assets. Given that the most recent figure that I have seen for the value of public entities under review by the McCarthy Group was 10 billion. That gives some indication of the scale of what we are talking about here. The programme also states that the government will be guided in relation to any sale by the McCarthy report. Given that this report, which is due to be presented imminently, is widely expected to recommend a large-scale sell-off of state assets, that is not much of a comfort to those who make use of the services of the ESB, Bord Gáis, or to their employees. Professor McCarthy is also likely again to recommend the sale of Kilche, in whole or in part. So despite the programme's commitment to merge Kilche and Bord na Mona, the 7% of this state's land under Kilche's control is by no means safe. There is much else in the programme that also highlights the departure from pre-election promises, particularly on the part of the Labour Party. There is much flowery rhetoric about education, for example. That is all very well and good, but there is no commitment to reverse the huge cuts in third level grants that will force thousands of students out of college and onto the dole queues or emigration. Labour has also compromised on the area of public sector redundancies, which will now amount to up to 25,000 by 2015. Each person made unemployed will cost the state at least $20,000, as well as the ancillary benefits. Nor is there any longer a commitment to these being voluntary. The reality is that in order to achieve the target, this government will have to sack people. The reality is that the people, Cúpulainn Omadhella, who will be sacked are those who are supplying vital public services. The reality also is that despite the commitment to safeguard frontline services, that the scale of redundancies targeted and the overall reduction in key public services for budgetary reasons will mean that it is inevitable that teachers and nurses will be among those who are sacrificed on the altar of austerity. Sinn Féin oppose any attempt to downgrade the Irish language and the axing of capital projects such as Metro North, which will deliver real jobs and benefits to local areas. We cannot cut ourselves out of recession. We will fight any attempt to lower the standards of ordinary people. There is a better way. There is an alternative. Sinn Féin has articulated this way.